Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's read a scripture.
Mji mukara ntawuni aya.
Matthew chapter 26.
Mata zora ashirinda shida.
Listen to that story very well.
Mji wana labari ndekeu.
From verse 6.
Daga aya shida.
I read it up to verse 13.
Harzu ago masha uku.
Listen very well.
Musaura ndekeu.
From verse 6.
Daga aya shida.
Yes.
Now when Jesus was in Bethany.
Da Yesu yena Bethany.
In the house of Simon the leper.
Agidan Simon.
There came unto him a woman having an alabaster box of very precious ointment and poured it on his head as he sat at meat. But when his disciples saw it, they had indignation, saying, to what purpose is this waste? For this ointment might have been sold for much and given to the poor. When Jesus understood it, he said unto them, why trouble ye this woman? For she had wrought a good work upon me. For ye have the poor always with you, but me ye have not always. For in that she had poured this ointment on my body, she did it for my burial. Verily I say unto you, wheresoever this gospel shall be preached in the whole world, there shall also this be, that this woman had done,
been
told for a memorial of her.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody will wonder, what do you want to preach from here? I say I want to give you the secret of how you will prosper, especially next year. This country, things will continue to get tougher for some time.
Nigeria, nang aba beze chikaba da zama da wahala na wone kima lokochi.
There is a recession.
Akwe wahala yenzu.
And it happens in every country in their history.
Akwe wone kasa aduni ala na ye kamfaru do mitarihi.
Always
there
will be a recession, because that is the time that the whole citizens, they come together and begin to think. Time of recession is a time for the country to put themselves together and know how to move forward. And what is going on now will take some time. Everybody will be crying, but we will not cry. I say we shall not cry. How many people say amen to that? Because our economy is not the economy of this world. Before there is problem, God has made solution already. Anybody that will follow the instruction of the Lord through this scripture, you will never miss it. Listen carefully. This woman came with expensive perfume and spices. Another account says it was Mary.
Angel was Mary.
She came and poured it on his head. Another account says and began to rub her feet. And the ointment, the perfume everywhere was scenting very fine. And the disciples looked at her. This oil you are just wasting it. They will have used it. It's very expensive.
You use it and
get money and give it to the poor. And Jesus Christ said something. He said, leave her. It is concerning my burial. That is what she's doing now. I have tried to look at that scripture very well to understand what is Christ teaching us here. There is only one thing I catch, and I've tried to share it to the people around me. We have an attitude where when your parents, for instance, that you are supposed to take care of them when they are alive, you will not take care of them. You are living in a very beautiful house in the city. In the village,
Akawye
is living in one hut. You are eating better food in
the city.
In the village there, you have left him there in that condition. You even hardly come home to visit him. The day he died, then you in the city, you will now start to arrange for his burial. He has died. They will carry the dead body and go and put it in a mortuary. Then they will scatter that house where Papa was living. Then they will erect a beautiful house. They will renovate the whole place. The road to that place, they will clear it. They will paint everywhere. They will put obituary in the paper. Spend thousands of naira. Then they will go and hire musicians. They will put posters everywhere. And then they will buy ashobi. They will buy uniform.
That's your uniform.
What is happening?
Make a farua.
The burial of my father.
Ah,
and they will spend millions of naira
million
to bury their father. How has that benefited your father? Amen. Some of you who watch us, I think 2 weeks ago, I was standing at the altar when I received from the Lord that before you cross over to the year 2017, go to your father, buy him a gift, and let him bless you. He said, anything your father say over you will come to pass. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And I began to think, it means somebody who has been calling upon God that my condition is not changing, that person has forgotten his father. That is the person's secret for the deliverance. Let's read some scriptures so that you understand these things. Read Ephesians chapter 6, verses 1 to
3.
Listen.
Children,
Yaya,
obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother.
Honor your father and mother,
which is the first commandment.
It is the first commandment with what?
Promise.
It is the first commandment with a promise. What is the promise?
That it may be well with thee, and that thou mayest live long on the earth.
That is the first commandment among the 10 commandments in Exodus chapter 20. The first commandment with a promise. Honor your father and mother, that it may be well with you, and that you will live long on earth
here.
And what does it mean to honor him? To honor your father is to give him the recognition that is due to him. You must see him as your father. You must see her as your mother. It is through them you came to earth. God has made your father and mother God to you. If you cannot bypass them and go to God and think that God will bless you, you refuse to bless your father and your mother, and then you are carrying that offering to your pastor. Listen, I'm telling you a secret. You have no right to bless your pastor until you have blessed your parents. Can I tell you something? The most powerful prophet in your life is your father, is your mother. That is the prophet that God has set over you. Look at the whole Old Testament. Look at the whole Old Testament. Any blessing a father bless the children, watch it, it come to pass. Any curse, it curse them. The curse will follow them. And they were not doing it in the name of anything. But we are doing it in the authority of a father. You will be like this, Reuben. And it comes to pass like that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm giving you a secret. See, I'm a pastor. Pastors have diverted the blessings of parents to themselves.
Pastors,
and cause the people to lose opportunities to be blessed. Can I tell you another thing? The best intercessor for you is your father and your mother. No pastor can intercede for you the way your mother, your father will intercede for you. Your father, your mother will intercede for you because you are from them. There is a special grace that flows from them to you. The love that the parent has for you is not the same type of love your pastor has for you. Many pastors, the love they have for you is because of the big, big tithe and offering you are giving them. The grace that flows in that type of love is not as powerful as the grace of a father and mother. When I was in school, I loved my mother. I attended the military school. It's a secondary school, it's a military school.
Secondary school, na sojoji.
They used to give us allowance. So during holiday, I would go and buy clothes. With that small allowance, I would come and give my mother. Immediately I give her, that woman will chop up. And dance and dance. And as she's dancing, she's releasing. I didn't know the effect. I didn't know what I was doing. All I did was because I loved her. Amen.
Amen.
But when God quicken this scripture to me, then I now knew what was happening. The blessings that I have today, they are blessings that came from the pronouncement of that woman. Church, listen. Let's read another scripture. Colossians chapter 3, verse 20. Colossians 3:20.
Children, obey your parents in all things. For this is well pleasing unto the Lord.
It is well pleasing. That is the terminology, the word I'm looking. It is well pleasing before the Lord. That you are honoring your parents is well pleasing before the Lord. And so Proverbs chapter 23, verse 22.
Verse 22.
Yes.
Hearken unto thy father.
Hearken unto thy father
that begat thee.
That begat thee.
And despise not thy mother
when
she is old.
Hey, she's old now. I bet this old woman. The older they are, the stronger their prophetic anointing is.
Read verse 24.
And verse 25.
The father of the righteous,
yes,
shall greatly rejoice.
Uh-huh.
And he that begetteth a wise child shall have joy of him. Thy father and thy mother shall be glad. And she that bare thee shall rejoice.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's just read some of these scriptures again. Read Proverbs chapter 10, verse 1.
Ten verse one.
Yes.
The Proverbs of Solomon. A wise son maketh a glad father.
Uh-huh.
But a foolish son is the heaviness of his mother.
Hey.
Proverbs 17.
Verse 25. A foolish son is a grief to his father.
Hey.
And bitterness to her that bear him.
How do you feel that a woman that carried you in her womb went through all the stress of childbirth, became sleepless all the months of your toddler, the toddler age, and you grow up and you abandon her and you expect that you will prosper? Your father that labored all his life. All his life he lived for you. And now things become better for you. Then you abandon him. How will he be happy with you? Read Proverbs chapter 20 and verse 20.
Yes. Whoso curseth his father or his mother.
Start again.
Whoso curseth his father or his mother.
There are some people that curse their baba, abuse
their mama.
What will happen?
His lamp shall be put out in obscure darkness.
Say your lamp will be put out in obscure, total darkness. You will never prosper. Favor will never follow you. That is the cause that follow any man that will treat the father and mother like that. Verse 26, Proverbs 19. Proverbs 19:26. Yes.
He that wasteth his father and chaseth away his mother is a son that causeth shame and bringeth reproach.
Read it again.
He that wasteth his father and chaseth away his mother is a son that causeth shame and bringeth reproach.
And so, when your father is alive, it is his entitlement. It is her entitlement, your mother, for you to take care of them. If you don't do it, your blessings will be blocked.
Albarkanka za tereshi.
No matter how much tithe you pay.
Koda kana bada zakanka yaya.
No matter what offering you do.
Koda wone irin bai ko kana kawo.
You will live a life of struggle, 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 struggle.
Zakaita fama haka.
When I gave this exhortation some years ago, people who believe in what we teach them, they put it into practice. And they begin to give me testimonies. I'm telling you that is the truth. If you are having a company,
in Canada company,
and you have staff, you are paying staff salary, or whatever at all you income you have, include allowance for your father or mother in your monthly expenses. I am telling you the secret for 2017. You see, pastors don't preach this type of sermon. A pastor will have been preaching to you now that you should bring to me and contest my God. Come to me and confirm my God. They will give a testimony of somebody who paid in some 10,000 naira and then he became millionaire the next
day.
Who wants to be a millionaire?
Here?
Come and try my God with 10,000 naira of
in
2 months time, you'll be a millionaire. It's
419.
It can never happen like that. And some people will foolishly go and give that type of offering. Amen.
Amen.
You see, our type of message is not acceptable. What I would have done is just demonstrate one anointing now. Oh, the Lord told me.
Allah.
And then they'll be running like
a.
Come on, so. Pack your money and go. And your soul has not been affected.
One
sometime this year, I went to Holland.
For
a program like this. A popular Nigerian prophet.
When he be the Nigeria, when I'm why she say
from Lagos.
The Lagos.
The same day.
Haka ya faru.
The same time.
Koranandini the local ching.
In the same venue.
Ah, would it there?
It's a very big place. So he was in one part of the building with his own crowd. I was in my own place with the crowd. We said to.
Ancheto.
Two Nigerian pastors are here.
Pastor China Nigeria Biusu Nana Akasamu.
And by the time we finished,
Dasuka Gama.
I think it was two or three days. Three days.
Kwana uku.
Yes, 3 days.
Kwana uku.
He too held his own 3 days.
Shima kwana uku.
The same venue. By the time we finished,
Dasuka Gama.
The man was calling offering from 1,000 euro. Confirm my God. They were coming in there. Reduce unto 500. They were coming to trouble. 200. Okay, the last one, 100. Come and confirm my God. While in my own here. I was sitting down here busy trying to teach them how to serve God. And they were receiving the Holy Ghost. And the first day, those who came with trousers. By the second day, nobody entered there with trousers. And then we went and we baptized a good number of people. So while I was counting the number of people that received the Holy Ghost and were baptized, that pastor was counting the amount of money he made in that. You see the two types of pastors? That is the type of gospel they like. What I'm saying now, somebody is saying, eh? Try try it and see whether I'm saying the truth or not. If there's anybody here that you have abandoned your parents, begin to take care of them. Now, did I say you should not take care of your pastors? The Bible says, give to Caesar what is Caesar's. And give to the Lord what is the Lord's. You don't rob Peter to pay Paul. You won't take the blessing that belongs to your father and give it to your pastor. Give the pastor his own. And give your parents their own. Give the offerings that you are supposed to give according to the Bible. Pay your tithe. But I am telling you, it is also a hindrance if you forsake your parents. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, some we say, but what if my father is the source of my problem? Do you know the Bible says you should bless them that hate you? That you should bless and not curse. If your enemy is hungry, what should you
do?
So if your enemy is your father, how are you supposed to conquer
him?
It is your obligation. Do your own. And be praying over it. And see what God will do. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My father is dead.
Baba,
it is settled. But there is somebody that brought you up.
Wanda ya lurade ke ko baya mutu on babanka ma woni lurade ke har kai girma.
He expects
yana bukata ke
maka. But you also care for him.
Ya lurade kamata ke maka lurade.
You should care for her.
Ka kuma ka lurade ita.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, I am an orphan. Nobody took care of me. It's okay, then you hold on to God. Because God is the father of the fatherless. But I'm talking to you who have a father living. Who have a mother living. Who have that uncle that labored and took over your well-being. Go to him. Go to your auntie. And bless him or her. Give the person something that will make the person to be happy. And tell the person to bless you. Of course, even if you don't say it, he will bless you. There are some blessings that when you give somebody, before you say it, the blessing will be flowing from the person's mouth to you. Do you understand what I'm saying? If you understand what I'm saying, can I see your hand? Can you clap your hands for Jesus? Remember your parents. And don't fail to pay your tithes and your offerings. And stand still and see the salvation of the Lord in the year 2017 in the name of Jesus Christ. Any question?